So much electricity, so much intensity. He certainly gives Raul Julia from Street Fighter a run for his money. Hello everybody and welcome to another movie review vlog. And today I am going to take a look at the final Thor movie in this trilogy. The newest one that came out, obviously. And I have to say, I am as fun and entertaining as it was rather disappointing, to be honest with you. So in this film, Thor comes back to Asgard to look for his father, Odin. But as it turns out, Odin is pretty much dying and or dead. And when the moment he dies, a new villain arises, which is Hela. And played by Kate Blanchett, I want to say. I'm pretty certain that's what it is. And pretty much just right off the bat, she decides to destroy Thor's hammer, cast him out to the far-flung edges of the universe, and destroy and take over Asgard. And boy, that's pretty much the plot, as Thor and Loki are stuck on the planet Sakaar and have to find their way back. Oh yeah, did I mention the Hulk was in it too? Yep, green all over the place, green with envy. Because, hey, we didn't make any other Hulk movies in the past, so why not cram him in here? This movie was about as messy as the planet itself. You know, Thor had an interesting run. The first one was good, the second one, bleh. The third one, it seems like with the new director and new writers, they just said, you know what, screw it, let's just have fun with it. And they did. Not the tee-hee ha-ha type of fun, but more like, let's just throw everything at the wall, left and right, just to make sure and see what sticks. Whether it be a ton of jokes, a ton of death, a whole bunch of action scenes, yeah, we'll make it work. We'll make it work, probably, maybe, not so much, maybe with some groups. There was a multitude of jokes in here that some did work, some didn't. I laughed at a good, probably 25% of them, maybe a little bit of a half, but overall, they just tried a little too hard. There are characters who try to joke casually, try joking a little too much, or ironically or unironically, and it was just like a complete mess. And about as messy as the planet Sakaar as well. And talk about fan base, you know. They brought back the Hulk, of course, played by Mark Ruffalo. This version of the Hulk is based more or less loosely off of the Planet Hulk storyline, which is a very, very good read. I highly recommend. But in this one, they just made a complete mess out of it. Like a very extremely quick, loosely based type of version of it. The planet itself is just littered with either garbage or just dirty environments or dirty people. And it's just like, or dirty aliens. Everyone except for Jeff Goldblum, who looks absolutely fabulous as the Grandmaster. And he was okay for the most part. A lot of the side characters that were very prominent in the first two Thor movies were either just shoved off, finally, or pretty much were killed off in the first 5 minutes. Warriors 3? Dead. Jane Foster? Oh, they broke up off screen. Eric Selvig? Who knows? But he's still around somewhere. Darth? No. We're not getting into her. Nope. She's gone now. It's done. But with those characters out of the way, side characters out of the way, a few more make their grandstand. The character Valkyrie, she was okay for the most part as a side character, but she came off as more or less like a comedic type of female version of Peter Quill with the constant booze and slumming around but could still fight. Yeah, that's fine, I can manage that. We got other characters like Carl Urban playing Scourge the Executioner, who was okay, but he didn't really do very much except for a couple of things, mostly to serve as fan base for the diehard Thor fans out there. And of course, Kate Blanchett as the villain, she was okay, she just kind of rushed right. Her presence was kind of like unexpected in the sense that she just came on in, attacked everything using her spike powers, and pretty much just laid waste to everything. She kind of felt like she was intimidating at times, but at the same time, she was really not that evil for the most part. She wasn't that very good at playing a goddess of death, if you ask me. As for everything else, the action scenes were okay, the fight scenes were good, especially for a finale, but it was, if you ask me, this trilogy, the ending for this trilogy is a bit of a letdown, because in some of the other previous Marvel superhero trilogies, there's always got to be some sort of significant impact to the character. Some way that fully defies himself as who they are, and in this one it really doesn't. In Iron Man 3, you had Tony Stark, who pretty much lost all of his iron armor and went all MacGyver trying to either get it back or trying to still be the hero when he fought the Mandarin. In Captain America 3, Captain America decided he just wanted to be the soldier that he is and really didn't need the shield. With Thor, he lost his hammer and developed the powers of Raiden from Mortal Kombat. That's pretty much it. Sure, he is the God of Thunder, yes, but apparently his ultimate weapon to defeat the villain, or pretty much a multitude of villains, was pretty much finally summoning electricity and absorbed it into him like a lightning rod just so he can unleash it to his enemies. And I was like, okay. And to be honest with you, this movie is a bit of a cluster and it just leads everything up to Avengers Infinity War. So, and with a multitude of other cameos in here from other Marvel heroes for 5 minutes. And I would have to say that this is rather disappointing and a huge mess. I mean, to be honest with you, Blade Trinity had a better conclusion than this movie. And not that I say it's the worst one, but it could have been stronger. But it's not nearly, this Thor movie is not nearly as bad as The Dark World, which I've already talked about in the previous video. So in the end, I would have to say it's a bit of a mess, and if you guys want to shut off your brain for 2 hours at a time just to watch some nonstop garbage action and partial fan bases, then this is the movie for you. For the diehard fans, the comic book fans, or Thor fans out there, it's a little bit of a disappointment because you get references from other characters, minor Asgardian things, and quite honestly, the prominent characters that were either featured or were planning to be featured in future Thor references or movies, probably never going to happen ever again. Because with Marvel, it's three movies and they're pretty much done. And with that said, I would have to give this movie 2.5 out of 5 stars. And I will have to say that this movie is not really worth the matinee price in theaters either. I mean, I would just recommend waiting for it to get it on DVD if you're really a true comic book Marvel fan, or wait until it's on sale, because to be honest with you, you can watch it once and can come back for it whenever you want, but it's not really worth it. Unless, of course, the DVD is on sale or something. And with that said, this concludes the Thor movie trilogy. I hope you guys enjoyed. Did you guys think it was that bad, or did you think it was better? Let me know in the comments below. And feel free to hit me up on all the popular channels with all the links in the description box below. And I've also ranked all the Thor trilogy movies in my official IMDb comic book movie list. You can check right below here. It's all down here. I don't know why I keep gesturing like this like a moron, but whatever. And also, later on this month, I will be concluding a few more comic book movies, more on the DC side of things, so stay tuned for that. And if you guys would like to support the channel, I do have a Patreon account, so hit me up on Patreon as well for the $1 month club, or for any special movie vlog requests what would you like me to review, or any other future BoobTube review movies in the future. And with that said, I will see you all next time.